I wanted to talk about cryptojacking, right? Which is, I mean, the name itself, it starts us off in a good way. Sometimes called drive-by mining, also a great name. This is the idea that we can trick someone, instead of maybe putting a virus on their machine, I mean, it might still be a virus, but we can trick them into mining some cryptocurrency for us, right? And that way we make a profit. Think of it like an alternative in crime sense to ransomware, where you're trying to get money off someone by taking control of their files. We're now just trying to use some of their CPU power to earn us some money, right? So theoretically, they mine some coins for us, they send them to us, and then we profit from those. So this all came about because a company called CoinHive decided that maybe instead of showing people adverts online, they could just use a little bit of their CPU to mine using cryptocurrency while they're browsing. And that way, they don't have to look at adverts and you still get paid for your website, right? Now that actually is not a bad idea in some sense. The idea would be that you go to, let's say, a newspaper, and instead of seeing a load of banner ads, you see a little ticker that says you're mining some cryptocurrency while you're on this website. And, you know, we're going to make a small amount of money off this in exchange for you not having any ads and reading the news for free, right? Okay, and I mean, the amount of money you're going to spend sort of a couple of minutes reading an article is not very much, right? Even if your CPU's on 100%. This is JavaScript. So you go to a website, it serves you a script which instructs your computer to start mining these coins. The problem is that it wasn't long before people thought, well, maybe we should just not ask permission, right? We should have them mine all the coins all the time. Right, and the other thing was that CoinHive has a feature which lets you only use, let's say, 60% of the CPU, so that there's some overhead for mouse events and things that are kind of important to keep the operating system running. And of course, the malware programmers thought, well, no, 100%. Right, so I've just got this web server set up on my machine. I've extended my classic blog. This is the world's best blog, of course. Right, it looks good and it's got good with a nice banner ad, which also happens to mine me some Monero cryptocurrency. Right, so let's have a look. So you can see here, I've got my blog before, it's got my comments and my cat pictures that I had before. And it's also got this lovely banner ad, which I've made for my shop, which is not a real shop. Don't send me any money. You'll also notice now, if you look at my CPU monitor, which I've also got running, it's sitting on 100%. And if we leave it for a minute, we're gonna start hearing my fan get louder and louder and louder, because basically the entirety of my CPU is mining Monero cryptocurrency now. I mean, I didn't notice, the mouse is still responding. I mean, you know, it's a modern PC. But, you know, you wouldn't necessarily know apart from the fact your fan has spun up. Now, it's also not plugged in, so the battery's gonna be draining pretty fast. The good news is that this is already less common than it was just a few months ago, because Chrome, Firefox, you know, antivirus vendors and things like this are all cracking down on these kind of scripts. Now, CoinHive, as I pointed out, is actually a legitimate company. They weren't intending on people abusing this service. So they've now got an opt-in version where a little pop-up turns up and you can say, I do opt in for this time instead of ads or something like this, right? That isn't blocked by browsers because that's a legitimate commercial alternative to ads. But of course, CoinHive aren't the only people that are making these, right? So you're going to have clones, you're going to have malware that does this, and you can just imagine that instead of getting ransomware, you'll just get something like this that runs on your PC instead, right? And it's the same is true also of phones. So you might download an app which seems too good to be true. Oh, there's not even any adverts on this free game, and maybe it's because it's using up extra of your CPU to mine cryptocurrency. If you were doing this in Bitcoin, you wouldn't get a look in, essentially. I could mine with my CPU Bitcoins, you know, for hundreds of years and never get any, right? Because compared to the size of the Bitcoin network with all their dedicated hardware, my CPU is a non-entity, essentially. Monero is slightly different. Monero has a hashing function that it uses in the mining process, which is quite hard to do on a GPU. And so you get some, but not a lot of benefit from having a dedicated rig, right? Two times maybe, right? Given the cost of a graphics card, not very good. So actually, you could have a lot of Android phones competing with big graphics cards in Monero specifically. And so in some sense, there is a point to do it. Now that's one of the reasons it was designed this way, to allow people on phones and things to mine. But it has this benefit that, or benefit depending on who you are, that it's a good target for this kind of malware, right? Because if you have a website where everyone is mining Monero for you, it's not going to make you a huge amount of money, but it will make you some. And Monero is one of these currencies that's a little bit hard to keep a track of, and so maybe you can get away with it. That's the idea. my browser and my extensions block it, my antivirus on my machine blocks it, the university firewall blocks it. So I'm currently, I have all of those disabled and I'm routing through my 4G phone connection. It works fine at home, I know, good or bad. So, you know, like I say, the vendors of things like antiviruses are taking a lot of steps to fix this. I'm going to close this now because it's not that loud, actually.
It's basically the thing that says many things for sale by now. That's got some JavaScript.
Well, yeah, I mean, this is just an image, but yeah, just next to it is some script that does it. You could imagine that if I was running a newspaper website, I'm being served ads by some ad company. All I have to do to get in there is pay some money to have an advert deployed, which also happens to have this script. No one's going to go to my blog, right? It's not online, but also because it's rubbish. So if I was an attacker, it would be much smarter for me to try and take over a site where lots of people are going. This came into the news because in February 2018, an accessibility website that does like screen reading and things like this was hacked, and their JavaScript file had some Monero mining code inserted into it. And this website was serving JavaScript to about 4,000 UK and US government websites, among others, including the Information Commissioner's Office and various high-level government websites. This meant that when you went on those websites to, let's say, find out about something important, you were actually mining Monero for the attackers. Not ideal.
Could you work out who did it?
Well, no. All you know is, I mean, assuming...
The wallet.
All you know is the address that the Monero is being mined to, right? And as usual, you've got the traceability issues of that. If they use that address to buy like pizza to their house, it might be slightly easier to find them. But if they try and hide it, it's going to be harder. This is a code that was inserted into all these government websites. This is not my code. My code is much simpler than this, and it's also not obfuscated. So this has been encoded to try and make it harder for antiviruses to find. And then this is the deobfuscated version, right? Which is essentially looking up the CoinHive JavaScript and then pointing it towards this address, right? Which you shouldn't mind Monero for because they're malware writers.
They weren't even writing their own JavaScript, they were using CoinHive's actual,
yeah,
their own code.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty lazy, really. Yes, so I think now some are writing their own JavaScript or embedding it into Java apps or for Android phones and things like this. But yes, when CoinHive first came out, this was, I would say, an unexpected side effect of their new idea. Right. Like I say, they've kind of come up with a more legitimate way of doing this now, and they have interesting things like captures, which do a little bit of hashing as an alternative to pick these images that have road signs in. Right, just do a little bit of CPU, which is interesting enough. But yeah, so I think going forward, we're going to see fewer of these deployed in a browser, unless they can find a way of getting around these new browser restrictions. But they might start to find their way into more actual malware, right? Maybe instead of encrypting everyone's files, you just take over their CPU for a while and make some money that way.
Or do both at the same time.
Yeah, why not?
The free games thing is quite classic because, I mean, we're all used to just getting games for free and expecting in-app purchases.
Yeah, when you download an app, it's got free access to your CPU, right? It could do this. You'll know because your phone will get hot and your battery will go like this. But that happens with some games that are poorly written anyway. So how do we know? You've got to hope, I suppose, that there's some vetting process on the apps, which might hopefully detect this kind of stuff. But it's not always going to be easy to find. And so you can expect a few of these to pop up from time to time. I'm going to say document.write. Okay, now that's just going to write nothing to the screen, right? So my comment on my blog is just going to be a script that does nothing. Okay, that's not very interesting. So let's do something a bit more interesting. Our PHP file takes a cookie and gives an image back, so let's just show it on the screen, right? So image tag in HTML, img is the image tag.